Hello everyone, welcome to the MATLAB and Simulink Robotics Arena. My name is Maitreyee.
Myself Veer, and this is the third part of the Modeling Pneumatic Robot Actuator series.
So let's quickly recap what we have covered in the last two videos.
Yeah. So in the first part, we built a pneumatic circuit using different blocks from Simscape, physical blocks from Simscape, where we saw that how the piston position was changing with respect to the change in a spool position. And in the second part, we built a throwing mechanism using Simscape Multibody,
where we perform multiple simulation by providing different position signals at the piston so that we land the ball in the yellow box.
Yeah, and that input signal can be termed as a reference signal, which can successfully land the ball in the yellow box.
But in reality, I don't think it's possible to provide such an input signal to the piston, right?
Yeah, because this piston position, what we have given in the throwing mechanism, 3D mechanical system, so that is dependent upon the spool position. Okay, so when we move the spool position, so there will be pressure created at both sides of the pressure difference created at both sides of the chamber of the piston cylinder, and that pressure will move the piston.
Okay, so in turn, the position of the spool is going to determine the piston position.
Exactly.
Okay. So how are we going to interface these two models?
Yeah, so this is our today's agenda. So in today's agenda, we'll be covering how to simulate the throwing mechanism with physical effects model in Simscape. It means that we are trying to interface the two models built in Simscape and Simscape Multibody. Okay. And second, we'll develop a control system to track the reference piston position.
Okay. So let's move quickly to the model and see how we have interfaced these two systems.
So this is a model where we have interfaced both the Simscape and the Simscape Multibody. And you can see spool input is input to the system and piston position is output of the system. So if you go inside this, you will see that we have two models. One is in Simscape and another one is in Simscape Multibody.
Oh, this is the same model which we built in the first video, right?
Yeah, this is exactly the same model which we built in the first video or the first part using the Simscape physical blocks.
And this is the one which we built in the second one.
Yeah, this is the same model. So now, as we said that, we have to interface this. So what we are going to do over here is, so at this place, we had a load in the first part.
Correct.
So what we are going to do now, we have removed the load. And we are trying to connect the real load. So what is the real load? Real load is the throwing mechanism. So the two mechanical ports now goes inside this subsystem where we have a idle force sensor. And now it senses the force, and this amount of force is sent to the prismatic joint.
So I understand that instead of the piston position, which was the input signal to the piston, the force that we get from the first model is going to be the input to the piston movement, right?
Yeah, or you can say the input to the prismatic joint.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So now let's go back to the main model and see what are the results when we run the model.
But the input that is given to the spool of the direction control valve isn't really able to throw the ball here.
Yeah, because in this model, the input is given to the spool of the direction control valve.
Correct.
In the last model, what we saw in the second part video, we were giving input directly to the piston. So here what happens is when you give the input to the spool, then it takes some time to develop that pressure difference alongside the two sides of the chamber. After that, it will because of the pressure difference, the piston will move.
Okay. So that means that the piston position isn't varying linearly with the spool position, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So how are we actually going to find what is the signal that is required at the input of the spool of the direction control valve so that the ball actually goes and lands into the yellow colored box?
Okay, so now we want to find the required amount of signal input at the at the spool.
Correct.
Of the direction control valve. So for that, we have made some changes in the current model and we have included one PID controller.
Okay.
So this is the model I'm talking about.
So what is this reference position?
So this is the reference piston position which we obtained from the second model. So when we perform multiple simulation and after that, we concluded that this is the signal if we apply to the piston.
Mm-hmm.
So the ball will land in the yellow box.
So this is going to be our reference.
Yeah, this is a reference okay. Piston position, or you can say the desired piston position.
Okay.
And this is our controller, and the job of the controller is to find to calculate the required amount of spool input.
Mm-hmm.
And this pneumatic robot system, this consists of both the Simscape and the Simscape multibody. Okay.
So let's just run the model and see.
The model. So let's see the results. And here you can see that we have compared the actual piston position and the reference piston position.
Okay.
And in the simulation environment, the mechanics explorer, you can see that the ball is landing in the yellow box.
Okay.
So now you have options that you can also tune the controller in a much better fashion. Like you can, this portion, you can reduce the error. But since our main target is that the ball should land in the yellow box, so since the target is achieved, so we are not going for more tuning.
Mm-hmm. I think I've shown a complete workflow about how you design a model like this. And I think it'll be beneficial for students who are participating in robotics competitions.
Yeah, so if they're participating in robotic competitions and they have some problems written where there's a target,
mm-hmm.
and an object, mm-hmm. and they have to throw the object in the target,
mm-hmm.
so this can be one of the models which they can use.
Correct.
If they're working on the pneumatic actuation systems.
Correct. So here are the key takeaways that we have from the entire 3-video series. We can build a pneumatic actuation system using Simscape, which we did in video 1. You can model a throwing mechanism using Simscape Multibody, as well as you can create an arena to test various scenarios, which we did in video 2. And you can interface Simscape and Simscape Multibody together, which we did in today's video.
To build the complete plan.
Yes. And finally, you can develop a control system to track the desired piston position.
Yeah, using PID controller.
So all the models that we have used in this 3-video series are present in a file exchange submission, which are linked in the video description. And if you have any questions or any queries of any sort, please feel free to write to us. And please do join our Facebook group.
To get the latest updates.
Yeah. And I think that's it from our side.
Yeah, now this is the end of the complete series. So thank you very much.
Thank you.